Well, guys, here's an update. It's the HB212. Obviously, sitting on jack stands. You guys probably won't know what's different. If you look here, nice and tight. Yep, got the axle changed. Front axle. You'll notice that this one is sort of broken. It's no wonder I had so much movement side to side. I just simply switched them, pulled the wheels, knocked out the bushings in the spindles, and put them in the new axle. I didn't change the bearings, didn't change dust seals, didn't re-grease nothing, just switched it quick. It's all gotta be pulled apart again and redone because it needs bearings and it needs to be cleaned, and I should paint the front axle at some point too. So, but for now, this is an upgrade. I mean, it's basically a lot tighter than it was. I mean, there's no movement in that front at all. I can sit here and shake it. I mean, I could loosen up the bolt and probably get some, but there's nothing there. Absolutely nothing. And of course, you'll notice I put the grease circuit in there. I got to thinking that after the grill and stuff is on, that's probably gonna be kind of a shitty spot. But maybe I'll switch it out for a 45 if I need to. We'll see how it goes. Also underneath, at some point I will do some more work here. I mean, I want to get everything kind of squared away, cleaned up, and double checked and whatnot, but it's a definitely improvement. I went ahead and cleaned up the engine compartment just a little degreaser. To me, it looks a whole lot better, but some probably wouldn't even know the difference. So yeah, that's definitely a good spot for now. Engine over there sitting waiting for me to get back to it. I taped off a few things. I gotta get it put back together as far as I can. I'm just waiting on those gaskets and seals. Then I'm gonna go ahead and take it up to a place that's a lot warmer than here, because this garage is not heated. Let it warm up for a few nights, and I'll go ahead and paint it. Just gonna shoot it black, call it good, put everything else back together, and you know, clean and adjust and recondition things as I go, basically. But that's where that is. This whole tractor needs to be tore apart and cleaned. It's full of crud. It's full of chafe. It's full of freaking mice problems. Had mice get in here while I let it sit for the last 7 years or whatever the hell it was. You can see, like, down there is mice. There's chafe and grass down here, and it's all just oily and dirty because I have a leak from the reservoir or something. And yeah, it's not pretty. Needs work. But I also need to make a fender seat pan catch for the back when you tip it up. I made one for that 2210 I had, and that was a good deal. I should have made two at the same time, but I have one to go by anyway. I just used the Alice over there. It's a rough idea, and I can modify it to work on here. You know, grab a piece of angle, make it work. That's all it was. You can see somebody had notched out my seat pan at one time, which kind of sucks because decal got ruined. But what I'm probably going to end up doing before I'm done is I will take a piece of steel. I'm going to put a cross on the inside and screw it into the holes that they left. Then I'm going to take my hole saw. I'm going to drill through here and make a round hole. I'm going to put in a couple of amber lights for the back, and I'll hook them into a flasher so I have flashers on the back for snow work and stuff. And then I'll eventually put on a rear work light, and I have the headlights. They're somewhere in here. There's a headlight bar. I don't remember where the headlights are. They're somewhere down here amongst all my junk. Yeah, they're over there. You can see them. Anyway, not that it matters. Yeah, that's pretty happy with that so far. Probably be the next step after this, after I get things kind of cleaned up. I'm gonna, I don't know, I'm debating on what to do. I really want to pull out that hydro unit and go through that, Probably going to pull it and replace it with another one I have that's known to be in working condition. Because this one leaks down and doesn't always want to work in the cold. But I have another one that's supposed to be ready to go. I'm kind of taking the guy's word on it, and I paid a prime price for it. Time, I guess, so. Why not? Might as well take the whole dang tractor apart and clean it up and shine it up a little bit. What the hell? Ain't gonna hurt nothing. She's a working tractor. It won't ever be. Probably won't ever get fully restored, but can do little things here and there to it. Once that engine's done, that's gonna make a big difference. That's gonna be the fun thing, is getting that back in, because putting it in is no big deal. Like, setting it down in here and hooking up mechanically is no problem, but that wiring was, they'd changed some things, and because it's a newer engine and carrying on. But I we'll see. It'll get done. I'll probably end up redoing some of the wiring at the time and trying to make it right and nice and clean, and it's gonna be a long project yet. Sorry I didn't film any of the process of the axle. I just didn't take the time to do it. You guys probably would like to have seen the tear apart of the bushings in here and all that. Maybe another time I have another spare axle. I can probably make a video on that for if you want. Just go ahead and leave me a message in the comments if you'd like to see that. I can certainly do that one day. Well, let's see. I think that's pretty much it for the update for the moment, guys. So if you have any questions, feel free to put them in the comments. Send me a message. If you like this video, please click like, and of course subscribe if you would like to see more. Thank you very much. Catch you later.